their names on your fable cup. The Pittsburgh Penguins were Stanley Cup champions 2009. And they mob goaltender Fleury. The Penguins hold on. The Wings have one last chance on the net. Fleury robbed them at the last second. And the Penguins have done to Detroit what the Red Wings did in Pittsburgh last year. And that's win in the Wings' own building. The Penguins, jumping for joy, obviously, have just surrounded their goaltender. They stormed off the bench, and the bench is just explosive down there as the Penguins win a Stanley Cup for the first time since 1992.
What a hockey game. What a hockey game. And the Penguins earned it, Mikey. They did all the little things in this game. They took the body, the bounces. Mark Andre Fleury was unbelievable in this hockey game. He makes two huge saves at the very end to preserve the 2-1 lead. And the Penguins.
Yeah!
Home, baby! The Stanley Cup is coming home!
Big Hal Gill with his arms around teammate Pascal Dupuis. You just have to know the sheer emotion of winning a Stanley Cup and what it's all about, unless you have been there and been around it. And I think more importantly, that you folks know that when you, it isn't just accumulation of a playoff series.
No.
It is an entire year of living basically with one another from the start of the season until the very end, 106 games, and you become part of a family. You really do. For the Penguins and this squad, certainly the rewards have been magnificent. What a story. There's so many side stories to it, Borky, that it's just so hard to really bring them all to the people. But the Penguins win it 2-1, back-to-back 2-1 wins, and they hold on, and they have done something I mentioned last night, Borky, that nobody in the world thought that this team could do, and that's win 4 of 5 against the defending champions, and they did it.
And the greatest thing in sports is happening right now, Mike.
Yep.
The handshake.
The handshake's here. Tommy Fitzgerald, a cup winner in the Pens, led by Sidney Crosby, who had only one shift in this third period after being hurt in the second. The continuing handshakes. Chris Osgood, the last man for the Wings, congratulated by Brooks Orpik and Sergei Gonchar as they come through the line. But certainly a very special moment for everybody as the Pens have won the Stanley Cup. I don't know how else to describe it to you, except that it is just pure excitement on the ice for the Penguins. And as I said, last year the Wings experienced the same thing. On the plus side, this year, their fans get to watch them lose the cup. For the first time since 1971, the home team hasn't won the Stanley Cup in a seventh game. Those numbers are made to be broken. They are. I mean, those long streaks. And yes, we are family from 1979. Let's give the Pirates a little credit, too, because they were the last team
Detroit
to win a seventh game on the road.
I thought they had this class.
Well, the numbers just, they're flying everywhere. This is the 87th playoff game of the 2009 playoffs. Of course, Sidney Crosby wears number 87. And the last team that won on the road in the game seven, that Montreal Canadian team, Al McNeil, was the head coach of that team. He's from Sydney, Nova Scotia. Go figure.
And one last thought. The man that led the Penguins to the first Stanley Cup, Badger Bob Johnson, was hired on this day in 1990 by Craig Patrick and the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Amen, brother.
So on June 12th,
said on those t-shirts, the pen's in your hand. What a story they've written. Dan Bylsma arrived and said, the sports writers will write it, but you really will write the story for them. Be quite a story in Pittsburgh and all around hockey tomorrow. We'll get the announcement of the most valuable player. Henrik Zetterberg was accorded that honor a year ago. Who will it be this year? We will learn in just seconds.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, the
direct your attention to the ice. The presentation of the Conn Smythe Trophy to the 2009 Stanley Cup Playoffs Most Valuable Player.
Let's congratulate two terrific teams on a great Stanley Cup final, the Pittsburgh Penguins and the Detroit Redwings. The winner of the Conn Smythe Trophy is Evgeny Malkin.
Yeah.
Evgeny Malkin is the first player since Mario Lemieux in 1991-92 to win the Art Ross Trophy and the Conn Smythe Trophy and to be the leading point getter in the playoffs as well.
Two power play goals in the Stanley Cup Final. He won that award if the Penguins would win the Stanley Cup, Doc. The way he played defensively in Game 6 swayed that trophy to Evgeny Malkin. And what a difference a year makes. Last year, he just seemed like he ran out of gas. Was really invisible in the Stanley Cup Finals this year. It all ends.
Just as there was a netmouth scramble around Chris Osgood at the end last year, there was one dangerous set of plays around Marc-Andre Fleury this year.
Most of them. I feel like a mess. Holy fuck.
So Evgeny Malkin celebrates with his teammates. Jordan Staal was called the X Factor, the important player on the team by Dan Bylsma this morning. He's pretty happy, why wouldn't he be? And a strong performance here, as he did have in Game 6, and he called him the best player in Game 5 in a losing cause, 5-0.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Stanley Cup.
Raises the cup. This is a guy that had shoulder problems in the